Meeting participants received an overview of the project, its importance to Saint Lucia, information on Saint Lucia's energy transition strategy, and the RFP process. They were also given the opportunity to ask questions, get clarification on the project, and to examine the proposed site at Latuni Viewfort firsthand to assist them in preparing their bids. Lucilec's business development manager, Victor Emmanuel, is leading the project. Speaking at the start of the meeting, Mr. Emmanuel said the company was, quote, pleased in the interest expressed to date in the project, particularly with the number of potential bidders from all over the world. Mr. Emmanuel also spoke of the historical context of the solar farm.
The development of this 3-megawatt utility-scale solar farm is another initiative aimed at reducing our dependence on fossil fuels while also aiming to stabilize or even reduce, and I think most people are more concerned about the reduction part, the prices of electricity on island. We expect that the drive towards RE will see more solar, wind, and geothermal systems coming online to meet the energy needs of the country now and in the future. However, we anticipate that these systems must be cost effective if the full benefit of these indigenous energy sources are to be felt by the average electricity consumer.
Lucilec will own and operate the solar farm. Potential bidders have until April 22, 2016 to submit their bid for the construction of the solar farm. The shortlist of candidates will be finalized on May 6th and the project will be awarded on May 20th. The submitted bids will be evaluated both technically and financially by a bid evaluation committee made up of representatives from the company and its partners. One of these partners, the Ministry of Sustainable Development, Energy, Science, and Technology, was represented by Permanent Secretary Sylvester Clozel. He spoke of the importance of the solar farm in changing the country's existing energy mix.
This is the start. There will be a lot more projects, and I encourage you to continue to work with us as we make that transition from nearly 100% dependence on fossil fuels to, we hope, by 2050 that we can be completely RE.
Lucilec intends to construct at least 1 megawatt of the project this year and develop the remaining project phases subsequently. The solar farm demonstrates Lucilec's and the government of St. Lucia's continued commitment to the energy transition process they agreed to when they signed the National Energy Transition Strategy in January 2016. For DBS News World, I'm Hannah Jiang.